I think a lot of people focus on what they don't want out of fear instead of focusing on what they do want. And you're gonna get what you see, what you're, you know, what you're seeking is seeking you kind of thing. You know, seeing what you wanna see, it's 99% of the time it's not gonna turn out exactly how you see it because, you know, it's not really our plan. But, you know, we can try our best with our human minds and use our creativity for our benefit as much as we can. And yeah, just, you know, if I have something to do on set, you know, seeing me on the mark, having the lights on you, you know, the director coming and giving you notes, you kind of talking yourself through, you know, prep or whatever you need to do, and just like really putting yourself in that situation. So when you're there and on set, you already have the feeling of, okay, I know how to do this. I've already kind of done this.
And you're right, it's true. When you see it, it's like it's already pictured in your mind. Like when I wanted to be a sponsored skateboarder, I had to see it before it happened.
Yeah, exactly. So it's exactly so true. Everything kind of starts with an idea, and then you can either let the idea sit in your head forever, or you can take action and do it. And as you start taking steps, you know, you notice the progress, and then you want to continue with it. Mm-hmm. It's like. You know, like you get like a hit of like adrenaline. You're like, oh, okay, I can do this. I can do this. I'm starting to really believe in myself. I'm in LA. I'm here. I'm doing it. I'm auditioning. Whatever.
But moving from Texas to LA, that's like a culture shock, right? Was that a culture shock for you?
Yeah.
And so how do you get through that as well with just being alone and not having a lot of friends and it's different. It's a different world.
Yeah. You know, for a long time it was pretty difficult because I saw kids that were a lot different from me and like where I grew up and who I kind of had associated with up to that point. And so I isolated myself for a long time, like just trying to do my thing. And at a certain point it was okay, but then it got to the point where it was like, you know, depression and anxiety and loneliness and all that. You want it to stop, but it's like, you know, you're in it. So how do you get out of that tornado? And I think the way that I did that was eventually like getting out of my own head and, you know, focusing on how good it is. Because again, once you see how good it is, you start to see all the goodness around and then more good comes. And then I get friends and a girlfriend and just everything that I ever wanted was already there. I just wasn't looking at it like that, you know?
So when you felt down and you were discouraged, you pretty much had to think about the positive things in your life. And then once you focused on that, it literally started to expand.
Exactly. And it's also what you're doing too. Like what, it's like you are what you eat kind of thing. You know what I mean? It's like you are what you are watching, seeing, listening. Like, so yeah, as I kind of started to change like my routine and you know, go to sleep earlier, wake up earlier, eat better, like, you know, things just start to chemically click, and then, you know, your whole world just kind of falls into place.
You have that discipline.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, and you've got it. Because it's easy to fall off track, and then once you do, you realize, you know, it becomes a little bit of a train wreck, and you just got to stay on track.
Definitely.
Thank you.
Yeah, thank you. Thanks, man. Appreciate you.